Good morning everyone, I'm Parveen. Today we are here to study 9th standard history chapter number 1, French Revolution. Till now, in this particular chapter, we have seen many things. In our last videos, we have seen that there was a monarchy in France. But due to monarchy, there was social inequality and economic exploitation in France. To fight with the social inequality and economic exploitation, the third state in France, French society, who are getting the burden of all the taxes, social inequality and economic exploitation, they started with the revolution and they made their own national assembly and draft a constitution. After drafting a constitution, they start. In our last video, we have seen that they started war against the king monarch and other countries who are helping the king monarch. And then finally, with the help of Jacob Club or Jacobians, in the leadership of Maximilian Robespierre, they won the war against the king. And then monarchy was abolished and France became a republic in 1792. After when France became a republic country, the leader of Jacob Club, Maximilian Robespierre, he took the leadership or he took the country under his own control. And when he took the country under his own control, there was like the France was declared as a republic country. There was a constitution in France, but there was one man rule in France, that is Maximilian Robespierre. And he acted as a one ruler or one man show in France. He does not give any power to other members or other legislature. He took all the power by himself. And he started, we can say that he started constitutional dictatorship in France. So the time when he controlled the France, that time is known as Reign of Terror in France. Because so many things was happened on that time in France because of the Robespierre, Maximilian Robespierre. He acted as a dictator in France on that time. He followed the constitution, but he took all the control in his own hand and he does not give any right or any political power to any other member or any other political party. So that is why that particular time, that is period of 1793 to 1794, is called as the Reign of Terror in France. And today we are going to learn about this particular period in France, which is called as Reign of Terror, which is between 1793 to 1794. At that time, Robespierre, he becomes the leader of the France and he took over all the power in France. And he on that time, he was following very strict policy in France. According to his policy, Robespierre followed a policy of severe control and punishment. He severely controlled all the members or all the citizens in France. And if anyone is not following his policies, he gives them severe punishment. So on that time in France, it is called as Reign of Terror because that particular time period becomes a time period of severe control and punishment by Maximilian Robespierre, who was the leader of the France on that time. Ex-nobles, member of other political parties, because see, ex-nobles, as Robespierre is the member of third state or a member of the middle class, what he thinks are ex-noblemen, clergies or priests who are the member of first and second state, they think themselves as our enemy, and that is why all the ex-nobles, member of other political parties and even member of his own party who were not following his policies, if anyone, or we can say that anyone, even its own political is even the member of his own political party, even his own supporters or other political parties, member of other political parties or ex-noblemen or clergies, anyone, if they are not following the policies of Robespierre, then what happens? Robespierre arrests them and they are imprisoned. Whoever is not following the policy of Robespierre or whoever is not following the method made by Robespierre, they were arrested and imprisoned. And after that, if the court found them guilty, they were guillotined. What is guillotine? It was a machine or a device which is introduced by Dr. Guillotin on that time. And by his name, that machine is named as guillotine, or that punishment is known as guillotine. Now, what is the punishment of guillotine? It was a device. It is consisting of two poles and a blade. And with the help of this particular device, which has two poles and a blade, a person is beheaded. It was a very severe punishment on that time in France. And why this punishment is given? Because people are not following the policies of the Robespierre, or policies or methods made by Robespierre. So that is why this particular time period, or time period of 1793 to 1794, which is headed by Robespierre, is called as Reign of Terror. Because if anyone is not following his method and rules and laws, that person got imprisoned and punished by guillotine, which means that person is beheaded by a device called as guillotine device, or that person is guillotine. So it was a very severe punishment on that time in France. And Robespierre made different laws in France to make equality in France. And what are those different laws? Now we will see that. He made the minimum ceiling on wages and prices, which means that he make a policy in which he says that all the persons who are working, they will get the minimum wages or minimum equal wages. If you are doing any kind of work, it doesn't matter. You will all get the minimum wages or minimum fixed wages. Minimum wages has been fixed. Everyone will get the same minimum wages, so that there should be equality in wages, or there should be economic equality, which is not correct, because everyone is having a different kind of work according to their talent or according to their capacity. But whatever work they are doing, Robespierre decided that everyone will get the minimum fixed wages, which is called as ceiling on wages. And Robespierre also decided that prices of commodities were also fixed. Whatever commodities are there, all the commodities will have a same price, or a fixed price, which is fixed by Robespierre himself. Meat and bread were rationed. Meat and bread were rationed to the poor people. Then peasants were forced. Robespierre forced peasants to transport food grains to cities. And Robespierre decided or fixed the prices of the food grains which peasants are selling, or which peasants are transporting in cities. And he also decided that all citizens were required to eat plain loaf bread. No one will have an expensive type of food. Everyone will have a same kind of food, which is called as loaf bread or plain loaf bread on that time. So that everyone will get the equal kind of food. Then he also decided that there should be equality in speech and addressing all citizens. Before, all citizens are addressing according to their status. If people are on higher status, they are called as sir and madam. But after Robespierre decided that all the citizens or all the people in France were addressed equally as citoyen, which means citizen. It is a French word, citoyen, which is called as citizen. There was no sir and madam. Everyone is an equal citizen of France. But all these policies of Robespierre are good, or were good, but they are forcing those policies on people. That is why Robespierre's policy were not accepted even by his own supporters. So all the people in France, even his own supporter, they raised their voice against the Robespierre. And on July 1794, Robespierre was convicted and sent to guillotine by court. So here there is a fall of Jacobin government, you can say, because Maximilian Robespierre was the leader of Jacob Club. So there was a fall of on July 1794, there was a fall of Jacobin government in France. So we can say that before there was a monarchy in France, then there was a constitution, and then there was a Jacobin government, which is headed by Maximilian Robespierre. After that, there was a directory rule in France. Now, what is directory rule? Directory rule means when Jacobin government fall in France, people or the other political parties combined together, they make a new constitution, according to which they denied vote to no propertied section. It has been decided that if a person has no property, that person have no right to vote. And they also make two elected legislature council. They make, according to the new constitution, there is a two elected legislature council. That two elected legislature council means all the person who are having a properties, they have a right to vote, and when they vote, they elect legislature council, where there are two elected legislature council, one is director, and in that elected legislature council, there are six members, one is director and other are five members in the legislature. But there was a, and why this particular rule has been made, so that there is a division of power, there is a legislature and there is a directors. Two legislatures are there, one is five members legislature and one is directors. And why this new constitution has made this particular policy, to safeguard the safeguard against one man power. Because before there was a king monarch, power is in the hand of king. After that, when constitution was there, the power was in the hand of Maximilian Robespierre. So to safeguard the one man show in France or one man power in France, they have decided to make two elected legislature council. But there was a clash, there was always a clash between director with legislature, because of which there was political instability in France. And by taking the benefit of political instability in France, on that time there was a military head in France named Napoleon Bonaparte. He took over the rule in France, and France becomes a military dictator after 1794, which we will learn in our next video. So I hope you will understand. Till then, thank you.